Okay then, so in this video, what we need to do is get this propeller here spinning, which is nice and straightforward. We're going to use a couple of keyframes to do that. So the first keyframe we need to set is on frame one, and it's the state that it's currently in. So make sure that your playhead is on frame one. You're then going to press S on your keyboard, which puts this red line down here and sets all these attributes here in red, so you know that keyframe's set. If for any reason S on your keyboard is not working, you can just change to your animation menu set, go to animate and choose set key, and that'll do the same thing. Okay, so that's good. What we need to do next is move on to frame 10. Ping! And then we're going to rotate on the Z-axis. You can see we're going through the Z-axis here. So on the Z-axis, we're going to rotate 360 degrees. So that's one complete rotation. Okay, so press enter on that. And then you need to press S or go to animate set key straight away to make sure that's working. So there you go, we've now got one complete rotation of the propeller. But we need that to keep going. So in order to do that, we're going to use the graph editor. So making sure you've got your propeller selected, you're going to go to window. And then you're going to go to animation editors and choose graph editor. And the first thing you'll probably want to do, if it doesn't show up neatly like mine, so let's say that it's really zoomed in or really zoomed out, if you just press A on your keyboard, it'll frame up your curve so that it's about the right size. And as you can see, it's got a bend at the beginning and a bend at the end, and we want to do away with those because it means it'll speed up and slow down, which is of no use to us. So I'm just going to select the whole thing, and then I'm going to change my tangents to linear tangents, and that'll be a nice straight line. Okay, so now it's going for a constant speed between frame 1 and 10, but we need to get it to keep spinning beyond frame 10. So in order to do that, I'm going to go to curves, I'm going to choose post infinity, and I'm going to let it cycle, which means it'll just keep spinning over and over and over. So if I just minimize that now and I hit play, you can see that that just keeps spinning, which is ace. And it should also mean that if I choose to move the plane, I'll have to stop it to show you, but if I move the plane as well, the propeller's going to go with it and it'll keep spinning. So that is a very good start to what we're going to produce. So what we're going to do in the next video is worry about how we get this plane to actually fly around. So I will see you in the next video for that.